I actually want to introduce you to a brilliant 18-year-old lifting up the next generation of girls with the magic of science. That's right, she's a self-proclaimed STEM queen, and she teaches hundreds of kids how cool science, technology, engineering, and math can be. She's a TEDx speaker and was one of Time Magazine's finalists for the Kid of the Year in 2019, not too shabby. Everybody, let's give it up and give a royal welcome to the STEM queen herself. What's up, Jackie?
Hi, oh my God, I am so excited to be here, oh my goodness.
Oh my, I'm excited too. So how exactly does one become the queen of STEM?
Yeah, so I live in a pretty bad part of Wilmington, Delaware. And living here, ever since I was young, I was not allowed outside. My mom made sure that I was indoors because she felt that she didn't want me to be in the wrong place at the wrong time and have something bad happen. Mm. So I have to find something fun to do indoors. And that something fun became science and STEM. I just remember when I was little, I would go in the kitchen, I'd mix everything I could find. And my mom was like, you know what, let's find a safer way for you to explore this little outlet you found. And she bought me science kits, science books, and all kinds of things. And I just said, I want to share this love of science with everyone else. So I would go to school and I'd try to tell my friends, and they would bully me and make fun of me and call me a nerd. And she would say, keep your head up and don't let your crown fall. And I really took that to heart. So as I got older, I said, you know what? I'm not going to listen to that. I'm still going to spread my love of STEM and call myself the STEM queen. Let girls know that we can be queens in this male-dominated field.
Oh my gosh. And by the by, I will be writing that down somewhere right after this show. I love that. So what do your STEM talks look like?
Yeah, so they're actually more of hands-on demonstrations because I know if I just watch someone do something, I tend to get pretty bored. So I like to have the girls get hands-on. So I have these big girls empowerment STEM events, and I have them about 4 to 5 times a year. And I invite about 100 girls to each event, and I lead them in all kinds of fun, hands-on, engaging science experiments. We make dry ice ice cream, we make elephant toothpaste, and the entire goal of it is to get them to see that science, tech, engineering, and math is not this boring thing that they can't do. It's something exciting and engaging that they absolutely should do.
Yeah, I mean, the smartest part of that is I was one of those kids that you could talk to me all day, but it did not, I had to be doing it. I had to be physically doing the experiment. Mm-hmm. I had to be, to learn what was happening and get it. So that's really smart that you're doing it. And that you're aware. I was not where you're at 18. I don't know if I'm where you're at 38. I'm gonna be real with you. But where do you see your STEM initiative growing from here?
Yeah, so for the last, 6 years? Oh my gosh, I feel old.
Oh, don't say that, ma'am. You are not allowed to say that on this show.
Oh my gosh, but for the last 6 years, I have positively impacted over 5,000 young girls. Wow. And that number, I really just want it to get bigger and bigger because the amount of girls that need to be inspired to get into STEM is, you can't even reach it. You know, girls need that inspiration every day because in a society that's telling them, you can't do this, you can't do that, they need that encouragement every single day to let them know that you can do this. So I want to continue to grow my initiative from just the city of Wilmington to the whole state of Delaware and to eventually the entire country. That's my big dream.
You are fully capable, ma'am. I mean, you started at 12, so I think you can do it. You have an experiment all set up for us, right? Can you show us?
I do. Yeah. All right. So, Miss Kelly, this is actually going to be interactive. I want you to tell me what you think is in this bowl.
Well, it looks like water, but it also looks like something's floating in it. Was there ice in it or something? It looks
so
like water.
So there's nothing floating in it.
Oh, okay.
It's
looked
not
like
water.
It's not water.
Guess. So this is actually called calcium chloride. Now, calcium chloride by itself is pretty boring. Yeah, you weren't going to guess that.
No, but I have seen that as an ingredient in things. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's really common.
Yeah.
So this is pretty boring by itself. You can see it just looks like plain water, but it's going to act as our binding agent for this neat little thing, which is called sodium alginate. Now, sodium alginate is actually pretty neat, but I want you to see what happens. I first want to show you that it's totally liquid in the bottle.
And it's purple, so my daughter would love it. Yep.
Yes, purple to match my shirt.
Oh my, I know, I'm telling you, my daughter is obsessed with purple. I'm like, I get it.
Oh, purple's awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and pour in this purple sloshy liquid, and let's just see what happens.
Oh, it's all like...
looks like something's in there.
It stays formed. Wow. Wait, what? That's so cool. Is
Isn't
it just one
amazing?
Long, like,
so
worm-like thing?
It's super long, super-duper long. Yep. Now, the neat thing about it is, so it looks like slime, feels like slime, but what's neat about it is you can actually eat it.
You are not going to eat that.
Yeah.
What does it taste like? What is it? What? I mean, I guess it's an ingredient. I've seen it.
Nothing.
It doesn't taste like anything? Okay.
I have been working on a recipe to make it taste like sour gummy worms for years now, and I haven't perfected it, but it's pretty cool. I mean, you get to make this awesome little thing that looks and feels like slime, but it's edible.
That's so cool that those two liquids just form that. I know that this is every day for you, but it's not for me. So it's super cool. Incredible. Thank you so much. Cannot wait to see what you do with your life. And thank you so much for what you do for younger girls, because they need the representation like you. They need a girl can do anything they want to do. And they need the light at the end of the tunnel. Like, oh, if she could do it, then I could do it. And that's what you're doing. Mm-hmm. I know you're also doing it for yourself, obviously, as well. But just so you know, a lot of little girls are watching you, all right?
Yes, thank you so much, Ms. Kelly. If you guys like this fun experiment, you can catch me on all my social media handles. It's STEM, STEM, Queen, DE. STEM, Queen, DE. Hope to see you guys there. Thank
y'all
you again,
Ms.
Kelly.
Y'all better check it out. Yep, I'm still here, just waiting for you to subscribe. If you don't, I'll be trapped in this box forever.